My name is Bert Ludwig. I'm coming from Germany and I'm the director of European Heritage Volunteers, a German-based organization that is working European-wide. When I had been asked to say some words for the Church Initiative, I was very enthusiastic because it matches with the work European Heritage Volunteers is doing. We are taking care for abandoned monuments and monuments at risk, mostly in rural areas of Europe, while bringing young volunteers, that means young professionals, aged between 23 and 33, to those monuments in order to support the documentation or the conservation, the restoration of these monuments. And a high percentage of those endangered monuments just in the rural areas are religious monuments. And we are currently, in this year, working in three different projects linked to religious heritage. On one hand, we are supporting in Poland the restoration of the interior of a Benedictine abbey. On the other hand, we are very glad about that we could achieve a cooperation with Jewish cemeteries, with the Jewish congregations, in order to support the documentation of the inscriptions of the gravestones of Jewish cemeteries. It is in Germany, but it is thought as a project which should be overtaken or could be overtaken also to other projects, to other countries, to other regions later, because the problem is that the inscriptions are giving testimony of the Jewish history. Often they are the only testimonies since the libraries have been burnt down, and due to the erosion the inscriptions are disappearing step by step. Yes, as I said, this project shall be continued next year in another European country. And last but not least, we could achieve to start a restoration project at a highly endangered post-Byzantine church in southern Albania, where we will be in a cooperation of Albanian and German organizations, and with the effort and the support of probably 18 national and international volunteers, reconstruct the roof construction and repair the roofing in order that the frescoes, which are currently highly endangered by rain, will be protected. We think that just the engagement for religious heritage in rural areas is very important, because often the religious heritage is the core of this, the heritage and also of the identity of the population. And what we are doing is just bringing together the locals, which have this identification, but mostly just in rural areas, they are elderly people, with young people coming from other countries, bringing in also the European dimension. And while coming there and supporting the restoration of the heritage, it has also the effect of an empowerment of the local population, since by this is a kind of mirroring, since by this support from by people that are coming from outside, the locals understand sometimes the value of their heritage that they had been underappreciated beforehand.